Hello, hello, hello! Welcome back to my channel, guys! Today's look is gonna be this full face tutorial on this like rosy gold eye makeup look. To begin it off, I'm going to prime my skin. It felt a bit dry and like needed a bit of hydrating, so I went in with this smoothie priming moisturizer. This is from HelloFab, it's their coconut smoothie hydrating primer. It literally smells like the Bahamas, like a beautiful little cocktail by the pool. It just smells so amazing. It's my favorite primer and it really hydrates the skin. Next, to hydrate my lips, I'm taking this Body Shop lip moisturizer in the scent mango. Oh, it smells so good as well. So I'm going to start off with my eyes before I move on with the rest of the skin. So I'm going to prime my eyes with my MAC Soft Ochre Paint Pot and just apply that all over the eyes with this soft crease brush from Eco. I am obsessed with their brushes at the moment. They are literally amazing, and I do have a like discount code for you guys, which I'll leave linked down below if you do want to check them out. I also go in and apply tape to the outer corners of my eyes to create a nice sharp line for this look, and it creates a nice guide as well for the wing liner that we do go in with later. And the first eyeshadow that I'm going in today with is this beautiful soft brown shade in the outer corner and crease. I'm using it as my transition shade and applying that with a soft crease brush from Zoeva. Next, I'm taking the thin Lizzie palette and taking this more kind of like brownie rosy tone. It came up a bit more brown on the skin, but it did look a little bit more rosy in the pan. And again, I'm going with the same shape, taking it along that tape, creating kind of wing, and also taking it back through the crease again, just deepening it up with a I think this is more definer crease brush from Zoeva. And I'm just creating a nice soft blend of those browns. Okay. Next, taking my Faux Couleur palette and that color Shrimp from the palette. It's a beautiful pinky rosy tone. This is the color I was looking for. And I basically whacked that baby all over the browns to really make it a little bit more pink, bring that rose gold shade in there, like that kind of vibe, you know. And then I'm going in and cutting my crease. I'm basically doing it halfway, so I'm cutting the first half of the crease and obviously filling in the lid. And I also kind of blend out the edges so it fades into the shadows in the outer corner. Then I'm taking this absolutely stunning shade. This is Blushing Bride from Napoleon. Oh my god, it's so beautiful. And I'm placing that all over that cut crease lid area. It's a beautiful champagne-y kind of pink shade. Really ties in well with this kind of rose gold theme. And I was literally living for it. It was so stunning. I applied it with a precise shader brush firstly, and then I went in with my finger to fill in the rest of the lid. Then taking Shrimp and mixing it a little bit with Coral Reef on a petite crease brush, I'm creating a kind of smoky wing. So really making that outer corner a little bit deeper and bringing those pink tones back, blending it into Blushing Bride. Once you've created your nice smoky wing, we're going to take a glitter liner. This is the Revlon Eye Art in the shade Topaz Twinkle, and I applied that along where the kind of two shadows meet, as you can see. So where that dividing line is, I created a glitter liner. It's thicker at the base of the lash line, and then it kind of tapers off into a thin point on the top of the cut crease, if you can see that. Then taking an eyeliner brush from Eco, and again taking the Revlon Eye Art Topaz Twinkle color. I'm using the actual other side, which I don't use much in my videos, but I'm using the kind of pinky shade on the other side of the tube. And I'm basically drawing a wing with that, making sure it's a really dramatic wing. I'm basically taking it almost all the way toward the end of the tape and connecting it up to the glitter liner. Then to fill in over top, I'm taking this Starlight pigment from Napoleon Purtis. It is absolutely stunning, guys. I thought this was a perfect touch with the look. It's a beautiful pinky rose gold shade. And I'm applying this pigment all over that kind of Topaz Twinkle liner with a precise shader brush. Once you've done that, we're going to go quickly and curl our lashes. Then I'm going to take some mascara. This is the Argenwear mascara from Physicians Formula. I'm cutting my lashes nice and thick. And then for falsies today, I went in with the Icona lashes in the style Make Him Miss Me. I think that's what they're called. They are so full and voluptuous and have that perfect, absolutely perfect, like elongated cat eye look, and it just complements this look so well. I'm obsessed. I literally love them so much. They make your eyes look so open, so lifted, so full, so fluffy. Like I'm literally obsessed, if you couldn't tell already. Next, I'm going to move on with the skin. So I've already primed it, but I just need a little bit more hydration. I wanted this look to be glowy. That is the theme of this look, is glow. So I'm going in with the Goody Co. Dream Serum Drops and applying that all over the skin. They're a great primer as well as like hydrating the skin. Then I'm going in with my Maybelline Strobing Liquid in the shade Iridescent. I'm applying that to the cheekbones, and then whatever's left, I'm applying to like above the brow. For foundation today, I'm taking my Perfecting Liquid Foundation from Airbon in the shade Neutral Beige, I think it is. I'm thinking that's what the color is. And I'm applying that all over my face with my foundation brush from Eeksho. Again, another obsession of mine. It's just perfect to get around the brows and the eyes and things with that nice sharp edge. Then I'm going in with concealer. I'm taking my LA Girl Pro Conceal in the shade Creamy Beige. And I'm just using the foundation brush to get right up close to that wing. And then I'm going in with a beauty sponge to blend out the rest of the product, like under the eyes, on the face, you know the drill. Then I'm setting that with some powder. I'm using the yellow banana-y shade from my highlighting and contouring palette from NYX. I'm also going in and applying some of those brown tones to really bronze up the skin. And I'm using my contour brush from Eeksho. It creates such a nice contour as well as giving a beautiful shade of color to the skin. So I'm applying those two browns along the contours of the cheeks as well as the forehead, nose, chin, jawline, you know the drill. For the nose, however, I went in with a brush from Zoeva. I think this is like crease brush or flat eyeshadow brush. Oh, classic shader brush, sorry, that's what it is. And I'm basically carving out the nose and then blending it in. And then I go in with my beauty sponge to kind of blend it all out, make sure it's all melted in, looks beautiful and seamless and all that jazz. To give it more of a glow to the skin, I'm going in with the BH Cosmetics Illuminating Palette, I think it's called. I'm taking that bronzy brown tone and applying that over where we've bronzed the skin. Then I'm taking this blush from Folklore and applying that to the contours of the cheeks to give a bit of a colour. And to highlight today, I'm going in with the Folklore Superstar Highlighting Palette and applying those two shades initially, the bronzy tone and the pink tone, over where we applied the blush and the bronzer to give a bit more of a glow. And then to give an intense pow of a glow to the skin, I'm going in with the lighter shade, that star one, and applying that to the very high points of the cheekbones. And then of course going in with my beauty sponge to blend it all out so it just melts into the skin so seamlessly. Okay, moving on with the eyes again, I'm going in with a nude eye kohl. This is from Models Prefer, and applying that to my waterline to really open up the eyes. Then taking that beautiful, beautiful pinky shade from the Folklore palette called Shrimp. I'm applying that with a precise shader brush from Zoeva, nice and tight against the bottom lash line. I want it to be really focused on the outer corner and just kind of tapers into the center of the eye. Then for my inner corner highlight on the bottom lash line, I'm going in with that fantasy shade from the Cool Tone palette from Thin Lizzy. For mascara on my bottom lashes, I actually went in with that Photo Ready Eye Art in the shade Topaz Twinkle and use the pinky side, not the glitter, the pink side of the duo, and apply that to my bottom lashes. I just thought it was a nice touch of rose gold, you know, to the lashes. It gave a bit of something else. Didn't take away from the look. It was just a little bit of something just to give a bit more of a pow. And also I felt like black, you know, bottom lashes would take away from that pink. So I wanted to just kind of really go with that rose gold theme. And that, guys, concludes this eye look. So moving on with the lips, I'm going to take my natural lip liner from Rimmel in the shade 049 Natural. And I'm lining my lips and filling them in. I like to overdraw my lips slightly as well, but it's up to you if you want to do that or not. Then I'm going in with this absolutely stunning lip gloss. This is my favorite lip gloss of all time from Napoleon Purtis in the shade Nude. And I'm applying it over top. Like, it just gives such a beautiful glossy finish without taking away from that beautiful natural color that I've done with the lip liner. It is so, so beautiful. It's my favorite lip gloss. And this, guys, concludes today's makeup look. This full face rose gold makeup look. I really do hope you enjoyed it. I had so much fun creating this. I thought it was a much more wearable look than from what I've been creating lately. I thought this was one you guys would probably wear on an actual day out rather than my, you know, butterfly makeup looks. So I do hope you guys enjoyed this rose gold cut crease. I had so much fun creating it and enjoyed my full face. I haven't done a full face in a little while, so I hope you guys enjoyed that. If you have any requests, of course, leave them down below. I would love to recreate them for you. And if you guys did enjoy this video, don't forget to give a big thumbs up and hit that subscribe button down below. Otherwise, I hope to see you in my next video. I love you all so much. God bless, and I'll see you very soon. Mwah. Bye, my loves.